Hello friends, warm welcome. Myself Dr. Sunil Patil from Mahatma Gandhi Vidya Mandir Loknetha Venkatrao Hire College, Nasik. In this session, we are going to study the introduction to cell, which is important for the students of first year and final year BSc in Zoology, Botany, as well as it is very important for the biology students, which are appearing for a medical entrance examination. Like NEET, MSCET and other examination. It is part first of cell lecture series. As we all know, all living organisms are made up of cells. We'll see the definition of cell. The cell is fundamental, structural and functional unit of all living organisms, or it can define particularly a cell is chemical system that is able to maintain its structure and reproduce. Cell are the fundamental unit of life. All living organisms or living things are composed of cells. Then we move to the discovery of cell. Most of the question in various examination ask on the discovery of cells. English scientist Robert Hooke in 1665 first described cell from his observation of non-living cork slices from plant. Robert Hooke first used the word cell or the term cell coined by Robert Hooke. After him, the Dutch scientist Anton van Leeuwenhoek discovered the first living cell in animals. A German botanist Schaden, who worked on the plant cells mostly, Schaden proved that all plants are made up of cells. In the same period, Theodor Scavone proved that all animals are made up of cells and with thin plasma membrane covering. After him, the Rudolf Virchow, who proved that the new cells are formed from the pre-existing one. Then we move to the cell theory, classical cell theory. Virchow along with the Schaden and Scavone are often credited together for the formulation of the classical cell theory, which includes three important things. First one, all living things are composed of one or more cells and products of cells. New cells form from pre-existing cells. And third one is the cell is the basic structural and functional unit of life. Then we move to the overview of cell, as all the cell having some common characteristic feature. We are concentrating on that common characteristic features of the cell. The first one is the all cells are formed from pre-existing cells only, as per the Virchow. Genetic information transferred through DNA from one generation to the next. The composition of protoplasm in different cell is basically same. Cell greatly differ in size, shape and the functions. For example, mycoplasma is the smallest cell, about 0.3 micrometer in length. Bacteria could 0.3 to 0.5, while the largest single cell is the egg of ostrich. In multicellular organism, human erythrocytes or RBC are about 7 micrometer in diameter, while the neurons are the longest cells. The shape of the cell may vary according to their function they perform. They may be disc-like, columnar, cuboidal, or even they may be irregular. Now we are moving to the next point, next characteristic of the common characters. Cell is the bordered by a plasma membrane made up of double layer lipoproteins. Inside plasma membrane, protoplasm consisting water, various organic and various inorganic substances. Cell organelles are membrane bound structures of the protoplasm. Every living cell consists DNA as a genetic material. Cell display homeostasis and remain alive. Protein synthesis is the important metabolic function which takes place within the cytoplasm with the DNA, mRNA, messenger RNA to form the structure of cells. Then we turn toward the detail of prokaryotic cell, or the first these types of cells. Cells are categorized into two large categories, that is the prokaryotic cell and the eukaryotic cell. Today in this lecture we are concentrating on the prokaryotic cell. The examples of prokaryotic cell: bacteria, archaea, cyanobacteria, that is blue green algae. According to shape, there are four types of bacteria: rod shaped bacteria are called as the bacilli, the round or spherical bacteria called as the cocci or coccus, the comma shaped bacteria called as the vibrio, then helical bacteria called as the spirilla. Now move on to the second category of cell, that is eukaryotic cell. The U means true, karyon means nucleus. There are two major types of the eukaryotic cell, that is plant cell and animal cell. In plant cell, we can see the green colored chloroplast. We can see a central large vacuole, a single large central vacuole, and cell wall. Presence of which give definite shape to these cell. These three things are lacking in the animal cell, that is chloroplast, single large central vacuole, and the cell wall. Then we are going to study in detail the prokaryotic cell in the next slide. The prokaryotic cell having envelopes, three envelopes. The three envelopes are very compact. The outermost envelope called as the capsule, the middle one called as the cell wall, and innermost is plasma membrane. This plasma membrane form the infolding, that is called as the mesosome. The appendages of this membrane are pili, the stout outgrowths, the femurae are contractile outgrowths, then very long outgrowth or appendages, it is called as the flagella or flagellum. For the locomotion, the pili and femurae, for the attachment or adhesion. Inside the cell, that is interior of cell or internal structure of cell, consists of single large circular DNA at the central position. Then it is called as the genomic DNA. It is without covering, so it is called as the nucleoid region. Then double stranded circular small DNA may be present. It is called as the plasmid. The cytoplasm consists many round structure. They are ribosomes, which are 70s types. Then it consists inclusion bodies. Then it consists vesicles. It is one photograph of a bacteria, a bacilli, E. coli. Then we are going to turn over to the detailed structure of prokaryotic cell. The prokaryotic, it is the Greek word, pro means primitive, karyon means nucleus. Means these cells are also referred as the cells without nucleus. In these cells, nuclear material is not bounded by definite nuclear membrane and represented by bacteria, blue green algae, and mycoplasm. They are generally smaller and rapidly multiplying, and they may greatly vary in shape and size. The four basic shapes of bacteria, as we have seen, the rod shape are bacilli, the spherical or round are cocci, the comma shaped are vibrio, and the helical are called the spirilla. Then next characteristic of the prokaryote, organism in which the nuclear material is not bounded by definite nuclear membrane, are called as the prokaryotes or prokaryotic cells. Then we move to the ultrastructure of typical prokaryotic cell. The ultrastructure includes, the first thing is the cell envelope or the outer the covering of the prokaryotic cell. It consists of three basic layers which are very compact and work together. That outermost coat is called the glycocalyx, middle one is the cell wall, and inner one is the plasma membrane. First of all, we are going to see first part, that is glycocalyx. The outermost coat of glycocalyx made up of macromolecules of polysaccharide and proteins, which help in adhesion of bacteria. Some bacteria have a loose sheath called as the slime layer, while other have thick and tough coat called as the capsule. So glycocalyx may be slime layer, may be called as the capsule. The middle layer, it is called as the cell wall. The cell wall is middle coat. It contains the overall shape. It is made up of peptidoglycan or murine in eubacteria, and it is made up of pseudopeptidoglycan in archaeobacteria. Then the one exception in the cell wall, that is called as the mycoplasma. Mycoplasma is bacteria that have no cell wall, and therefore they does not having the definite shape. Then we move to the innermost coat, that is the cell wall. Before that, the cell wall of different bacteria shows different reaction to the gram stain. The bacteria which retain the stain called as the gram positive, and those which not are called the gram negative. Accordingly, there are these are two large groups of bacteria, gram positive and gram negative. Then we move to the third part, that is the innermost coat as the plasma membrane. The plasma membrane, it is lipid bilayer similar to the plasma membrane of other cell. These are numerous project protein moving in or on this layer that transport waste ion and numerous across the membrane, nutrients across the membrane. This plasma membrane form infolding called the mesosome. So one more part is the mesosome. Infolding of plasma membrane into the cell are called the mesosome. The mesosome forms a finger-like tubule, structure called the tubules. Of the, if they are sac-like, they are called the vesicle. If they are branch structure, they are called the lamellae. So mesosomes are either tubule, either vesicle, or either lamellae. There are types of mesosome. They have the, these are the function. They help in the cell wall formation, DNA replication, and also help in the secretion process. Helps in the respiration to increase the surface area of the plasma membrane. In some bacteria, like cyanobacteria, there are other membranous extension of the mesosome called the chromatophores with pigment. So they are called the chromatophore. The cyanobacteria is the example. Then we move to the appendages of the prokaryotes. The prokaryote may have following appendages. The first one is the pili or femoris. They are hollow hair-like extensions made up of protein. Allow prokaryotes to attach to other cells for the adhesion or attachment pili. One particular type of pilus, that is sex pilus, allows the transfer of DNA from one prokaryote to another. Pili are also called as the femori. Then second appendage is flagella or flagellum. Flagella are long appendages which rotate by means of motor located under the plasma membrane or cytoplasmic membrane. They are used to move the cell around. Prokaryotes may have one or few or many flagella. Then we move to the internal structure of the prokaryote. Internally, prokaryotic have cytoplasm, DNA, plasmid, and ribosome. Cytoplasm, DNA, plasmid, and ribosome are the internal structure. The membrane bound organelles are completely lacking. There is no any membrane bound organelle in the prokaryotic cell. So first of all, we are going to study the cytoplasm, which is viscous substance covered by plasma membrane. It consists mainly water, protein, lipid, carbohydrate, ribosome, different types of RNA molecules, enzymes, salts, and various organic molecules. Second thing, that is inclusion bodies, non-living thing, a kind of storage granule lies free in the cytoplasm are called the inclusion body. These are of two types. Organic inclusion include the cyanophysian starch granule and glycogen granule. And the inorganic inclusion include the phosphate and the sulfur granules. Then we move to the third internal structure, that is nucleoid. It consists of long circular DNA found in the central region. The though it is not surrounded by membrane, it is referred as the nucleoid instead of nucleus. It is visibly separated from the rest of the cell interior. It is connected to the plasma membrane through mesosome. Then we move to the fourth internal structure, that is ribosomes. Ribosomes are 70S type. The large subunits are 50S and small subunits are 30S. S stands for the Swedberg unit of sedimentation coefficient. They do the same job translating the mRNA, messenger RNA, so as to produce the protein. The fifth structure, it is the plasmid. It is the prokaryotic cell may show one or more additional circular double-stranded DNA called as the plasmid. The function of plasmid is antibiotic resistance and fertility. The genetic in genetic engineering, plasmids are used for gene transfer, gene amplification, etc. In certain states or condition of the prokaryote, endospore is one thing. Endospore, some prokaryotes form spores in adverse condition that are very resistant to drought, high temperature, and other hazards of nature. In favorable condition, the spores germinate to create an active prokaryote. Here we are also going to see one example, some characteristic of Escherichia coli. E. coli is a gram-negative monotrichous symbiotic bacilli of colon of human being and other invertebrates. It is heterotrophic and non-pathogenic bacteria producing some vitamins. Example, vitamin K for human use. It is one of the best studied bacteria. One of the best studied bacteria, since it is easy to grow in artificial medium where it can divide every 20 minutes at 37 degree centigrade under optimal condition. So these are some references I have used for this presentation. As we next video is the eukaryotic cell, do watch the next video. Thank you, have a nice day.